Good morning. And welcome to worship at First Presbyterian Church of Waukesha. Whether you are joining us in person or online, we're glad you were all here with us this morning or whenever you happen to watch it. There are plenty of activities that are in January, but we've decided to forego many of those announcements just so we can continue to celebrate the birth of baby Jesus. But I do want to give an opportunity in case there is something that you would like to announce that you have that maybe we're not aware of. Well, with that, let's take a moment to welcome God into our hearts and minds as we prepare to worship. I now invite you to stand as you are able and join me in our responsive call to worship that is in the bulletin. We waited.
And imagined the Savior.
We imagined power.
One like the world, but stronger and on our side.
We imagined someone on a white horse wielding a sword.
We had a baby born in the stable on my side.
We imagined the work done for us through the destruction of our enemies. Praise be to God for the unexpected babe of Bethlehem.
Praise to the wisdom of Allah. Amen.
Thank you.
As we enter this new Christmas season and approach this new year, let us set aside our old ways that led to separation and embrace each new opportunity Christ presents us. Let us confess first out loud and then in the silence of our hearts. Together we pray. Grant, O God, that your holy and life-giving Spirit may so move every human heart, and especially the hearts of the people of our country, that barriers which divide us may crumble, suspicions disappear, and hatred cease, that our divisions being healed, we may live in justice and peace.
Scripture says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The Word was in the beginning with God, and all things came into being through the Word, and without the Word, not one thing came into being. Friends, believe the good news of the gospel. In Jesus Christ, we are forgiven. May the peace of Christ be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us show each other a sign of that peace, and don't neglect the people in the balcony. The first scripture reading today comes from Psalm 148. Listen for God's word. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise the Lord from the heights. Praise God, all his angels. Praise him, all God's hosts. Praise him, sun and moon. Praise him, all you shining stars. Praise him, you highest heavens and you waters above the heavens. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for he commanded and they were created. He established them forever and ever. He fixed their bounds, which cannot be passed. Praise the Lord from the earth, you sea monsters and all depths, fire and hail, snow and frost, stormy wind fulfilling his command. Mountains and all hills, fruit trees and all cedars, wild animals and all cattle, creeping things and flying birds, kings of the earth and all peoples, princes and all rulers of the earth, young men and women alike, old and young together, let them praise the name of the Lord. For God's name alone is exalted. God's glory is above the earth and heaven. God has raised up a horn for his people, praise for all of his faithful, for the people of Israel who are close to him. Praise the Lord. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Let's pray. Lord, it is amazing that you come. The snow may not be on the ground quite yet, but still, how silently you creep into our lives and to our hearts. The wondrous word has been given to us. So venite, come. Come into this sanctuary, come into this music, come into these words so sacred to us, and help them lodge deep in our hearts. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Second reading comes to us, one of my favorite readings of all time, from Colossians chapter 3, starting with verse 12. Listen to the affirmations in here. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility and meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other. Just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you must also forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you were called in the one body. And be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish each other in all wisdom and with gratitude in your hearts. Sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God, our Maker, through him. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Our scripture lesson today comes from, our gospel lesson today comes from Luke chapter 2, beginning with verse 25. Listen for God's word. Now there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon. This man was righteous and devout, looking forward to the consolation of Israel, and the Holy Spirit rested on him. It had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Messiah. Guided by the Spirit, Simeon came into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him what is customary under the law, Simeon took him in his arms and praised God, saying, "Master, now you are dismissing your servant in peace according to your word. For my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared in the presence of all people, a light for revelation to the Gentiles and for glory to your people Israel." And the child's father and mother were amazed at what was being said about him. And then Simeon blessed them and said to his mother Mary, "This child is destined for the falling and rising of many in Israel, and to be a sign that will be opposed, so that the inner thoughts of many will be revealed. And a sword will pierce your own soul too." There was a prophet, Anna, the daughter of Phanuel in the tribe of Asher. She was of great age, having lived with her husband 7 years after her marriage, and then as a widow to the age of 84. She had never left the temple, but worshiped there with fasting and prayer night and day. And at that moment she came and began to praise God and to speak about the child to all who were looking for the redemption of Israel. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
When I was growing up, my father was a lawyer in Chicago area. But really, what he was that he was a man filled with music. He grew up in Peoria, Illinois, with a family who was not very wealthy because, you see, his dad died when he was 6 years old, going into work. If his dad had died at work, the family would have been covered by workman's compensation, but instead, his dad died right at the street corner where the streetcar was coming. And so my grandmother had to make do. She had to call in favors, frankly. And she got a job as the janitress in the local elementary school that was, she could look out of the windows and see her house, see the house that they lived in. So she could keep an eye on her kids in the late afternoon when she wasn't home, and they were. Well, one of the jobs that my dad got early on was that he became part of the Episcopalian boy choir downtown. And he would go and sing in the choir and get 25 cents for doing so, which then he would go to the local movie theater and see the double bill and be able to afford a hot dog and some soda. And he'd sit through the Tom Mix or whatever else it was that was playing. But always there was music. When I talked to my aunt about growing up with my dad, she said, well, you know, your dad and I played piano together on the radio, but I was so black and blue after that performance, I would never do that again with him because he would pinch me in the middle of this performance. And so they would be playing duets, and my father would reach over and pinch my aunt. All right. So, boys and girls, families, right? Well, he sang whenever he could in church choirs. He sang. He sang in what's known as the Great Lakes Dredge and Philharmonic Society in Chicago, and I would see him singing Christmas carols in various people's houses on the near north side of Chicago. But then he decided that in our local music center, that he would become one of the people that would sing a solo during their celebration, Christmas celebration. But he would draft each of us kids into helping him. And I don't know if you know what today is, but today is St. Stephen's Day. So he would sing Good King Wenceslas. And maybe you know this song and maybe you don't, but it goes like this. Good King Wenceslas looked out on the feast of Stephen, December 26th, when the snow lay round about, deep and crisp and even. Brightly shone the moon that night, though the frost was cruel. When a poor person came in sight, gathering winter fuel. And then my dad would sing, hither, page, and stand by me. If thou knowest it, tell me. Yonder peasant, who is he? Where and what his dwelling? And then in the squeaky little voice that I had, my brother before him, my sister before him, before me, and my brother before her, sire, he lives a good league hence underneath the mountain, right against the forest fence by St. Agnes Fountain. Bring me flesh and bring me wine, my father would sing. Bring me pine logs hither, thou and I will see him dine when we bear them thither. Page and monarch, forth they went together, through the rude wind's wild lament and the bitter weather. And then my part. Sire, the night is darker now, and the wind blows stronger. Fails my heart, I know not how, I can go no longer. And then my dad. Mark my footsteps, my good page, tread thou in them boldly. Thou shalt find the winter's rage freeze thy blood less coldly. And then all of the people sang. In his master's steps he trod where the snow lay dinted. Heat was in the very sod which the saint had printed. Therefore, Christian folk, be sure, wealth or rank possessing, ye who now will bless the poor, shall yourself find blessing. No matter what we think, Christmas comes to us, unbidden and unexpected, no matter if we're celebrating or if we're grieving. No matter if we're missing loved ones or been surprised by unexpected visitors, Christmas comes and comes to us no matter what we're feeling. And the child silently knocks on the doors of our hearts and says, will you welcome me? Do I find room in your house? Will you open your door and let me in? That's what the peasant had to do with good King Wenceslas. He might have come with all of his gifts, with his poor frozen page, but remember, he had to open the door, that poor one. We have to open our doors, us poor ones, and allow Christmas in. God's love, come to us. Let's pray. Lord, we might hear your knock on our door in the midst of incredible celebration, with our tables filled with people that we love, or our table filled with memories of the people that we love. We may come to this moment and hear your knock, and we may be in need of your forgiveness for words we said in haste or misunderstandings that we did not clear up. We may hear your knock and are so bitter by how life has turned out for us that we can't believe that you would knock on our door now. what you do. Year after year, day after day, hour after hour, you knock on our door in wonder and call us to allow you in. And when we allow you in, you call us forward into a future that you have prepared for us, into the great feast where all are welcomed, into the wonder of your love. Even as frosty winds make moan, even in the silence of a midnight clear, so now, Lord, come to us. Enter in. And have us give you the only thing you truly want this Christmas. To give you our heart. As bitter or as in full of love, as in grief, or as in wonder and praise, or all of that all combined. Thank you. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Let's pray. You came down that we might have love. You came down that we might have peace. Came down that we might have joy. You came down that we might have hope. And hope does not disappoint us. Thank you, incarnate Word, for this moment of worship, and have it mark us in the days to come. We pray in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. The angels were announcing to shepherds, migrant workers, that Jesus was born. And who came? The migrant workers came. Outsiders of the covenant came to worship Jesus, born in a cave. And we get to come too. May the blessings of Almighty God, the Creator, the Christ, and the Holy Spirit remain with us now and always. Merry Christmas to you all and Happy New Year. This is the 12 days of Christmas. Let's enjoy them.